problem as well as like a boredom thing. I like that philosophically. It's like boredom's kind of, it's niggling at you kind of thing. Do you know what I mean? Rather than just, yeah. So, good. So let's say I was happy. J'étais content. Give me, I was very happy.
J'étais très content.
Good. Give me slang French. I was really happy. Let's run through them. So you can say, j'étais trop content, which in this context won't mean I was too happy, as in my level of happiness was too much.
Okay.
Yeah, you can, oh putain, mais j'étais trop content, quoi. I was really happy, j'étais trop content. Also, you can say, j'étais, now it depends on the generation. So, hyper is probably the one I'd go with. It's like wicked. Oh, it was wickedly, you know, oh my God, man, it was wicked. It's sometimes on some people, or it was sick, or it was fat.
Yeah.
It depends where you are on the age scale, which one you'd use, okay? If my grandma went, oh, it was brilliant, fine. If she went, it was super, like older people tend to say, I'd believe it. If she went, oh, man, it was fat, with P-H-A-T, I'd be a bit like, hmm. So hyper is one which we use. Archi is a bit of a modern one. Yeah, mega, super is a bit dated, so we've got super, mega, ditch those. Archi, super sympa, we still say super sympa. Super is a bit more of a proper word. Hyper is still used. Oh, mais c'était hyper cher, it was really expensive. C'était archi cher. I'd use hyper. Let hyper be your other one, okay? So hyper you could use in an exam, okay? You went to France recently, tell me about that. Oh, c'était hyper facile, it was really easy. I just took the tube, I just took the Eurostar. Yeah, j'ai pris l'Eurostar, c'était hyper facile. So that's one you can use in your exam. Good, okay. So, maintenant, on va parler normalement. Donc, qu'est-ce que tu as fait hier soir après être rentré de l'école? Qu'est-ce que tu as fait hier soir après être rentré de l'école? Quelle était la première chose que tu as faite après être rentré de l'école? Donc, tu arrives à la porte et quoi? Quoi d'autre? Qu'est-ce qui se passe?
Ok. Il faut que je pense. Mm-hmm. Je ne me souviens pas.
Good, now. Good. Cleaning it up, good. So, il faut que j'y pense, because you have to think to something. Okay. Yeah, 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 yeah. So, penser à, I'm thinking of you, Luke. Je pense à toi. Okay? Or, what is the verb which means penser à quelque chose on its own? Not that you'd use it with something afterwards, but what's the verb to think about something? Réfléchir. Good. Bearing in mind what we said about mincir, can you say, I need to think, using réfléchir? Il faut que je...
réfléchisse.
Très bien, il faut que je réfléchisse. Now, remember, in French, that's quite heavy in the mouth, so que je réfléchisse, you could do a cheeky instant subjunctive, which are not to be used in essays, but only for oral, or que je réfléchisse. Il faut réfléchir. If you don't bring in a new agent, a new subject, we just assume it's on about you. Oh, il faut réfléchir. But I would personally say, il faut que j'y pense. Laisse-moi y penser. Oh, let me think about it. Laisse-moi y penser. Good, okay. Lovely. Now, se souvenir and se rappeler, again, they normally like, they like objects. So, je m'en souviens plus, I don't like, my point here being the addition of the en rather than the plus, I don't remember anymore, je ne m'en souviens plus, je m'en souviens plus, ou je m'en rappelle plus, lovely, ou j'ai du mal à y penser, does that kind of grammar make sense? So, go again, say, let me think, I need to think about it, no, let me think, I need to, because I don't remember.
Laisse-moi y penser parce que je ne me souviens pas.
Good, okay. Je ne m'en souviens pas, okay.
Can I drop the ne?
Yeah. As long as you.
It's so annoying, but in school they're always on about keeping it in.
Yeah. Right. Okay. So how do I put this? You need to be able to have it if you're in a VU level of conversation. Yeah, you absolutely need to be able to have it in a VU level of conversation.
Mm-hmm.
For the moment, I always say if somebody's struggling putting the nut in. Somebody prefers it without, fine, excellent. It shows me two things. It shows me that the person's finding the right balance for the other adverb. So, enfin, j'ai pas mangé, j'ai rien mangé. That's great. It also shows me that the person is enjoying working their way through the sentence. That's great. If it shows me that the person's not comfortable enough with vowels, and so, for example, they find the no hard because it's like, it's too many little... consonants, then no. But yeah, so basically, always make sure you can say it. It's like using nous as opposed to en. Make sure you can do it, but yeah. So, I would say je m'en souviens plus. I would not say je ne m'en souviens plus. I don't think I've said je ne m'en souviens plus with people I know in the last 4 months, unless I'm teaching. Yes, je, ouais, moi, je m'en souviens plus, quoi. Yeah, je ne m'en souviens plus. But make sure you can get the je ne m'en down. Okay, je ne m'en. Okay, it's like a little trim. It's like a little trill. Okay. Lovely. Okay, because... So, oui, donc dis-moi, laisse-moi y penser, laisse-moi réfléchir parce que je ne m'en souviens plus. Okay. Good. Now, think. Think. Think in French out loud. Alors, qu'est-ce que j'ai fait? Donc, je suis... It said go through it. Like, think. I'm in a verb of transport, so I'm probably going to be je suis... Don't get it ready and then come for me. Yeah? Go, think through it with us and bas and fin. Let me hear. What did you do?
Okay.
So, why is the silence?
Oh, sorry.
No, my point being, don't be silent. Be like, oui. Imagine yourself. Je suis... Je suis. So if you go, oh, I did what? J'ai need to change, talking about transport. Je suis arrivé à 17h après, you know, whatever. Think through it. Go. Tell me what you did when you got back from school yesterday.
Okay. Qu'est-ce que j'ai fait? Je suis arrivé à la maison. Et après avoir regardé la télévision.
Oui. Careful, no, just a little thing. Just say, un peu de, enfin, j'ai regardé un peu de télé après avoir regardé un peu de télé. Juste pour que tu saches, just so that you know, officially, there used to be two words. Officiellement, il y avait deux mots. Télé, as in télévision, was the medium, and télé, as in le téléviseur, was like, you know, the box that you watch. So just remember that the box, like anybody watches a square box telly these days as opposed to a flat screen. Give me the word for flat screen, écran plat.
Écran plat.
Okay, or grand écran, big screen kind of thing. Okay, lovely. Qu'est-ce que t'as regardé? Qu'est-ce que tu as regardé?
Do you just like say films in English?
The titles of the films.
Yeah.
Okay, so what you would say is say okay. So translate for me. Say, I imagine there are titles in French. Just say for me. I imagine.
J'imagine.
There are.
J'imagine qu'il y a.
Lovely. Titles in French.
Des titres en français.
Good reflex to not go titre. Good, okay. Enfin, j'imagine il y a des titres en français, évidemment. But I haven't seen them.
Mais je les ai pas vus.
Lovely. Je les ai pas vus for the moment. Pour la moment, does that sound right for you?
Pour le moment.
Good. Up until now?
Jusqu'à maintenant.
Good. Spell jusqu'à for me.
J-U-S-Q-U apostrophe A.
With what on the A?
The accent crack.
Good. Good. Préposition à. Excellent. Okay, jusqu'à maintenant, je... Effectively, oui, j'en ai pas entendu parler. I haven't heard about them. In French, we have to say I haven't heard talk about them. Oui, donc qu'est-ce que tu as regardé comme film? Remember that format. What have you watched as film? Ok, qu'est-ce que tu as regardé comme film?
J'ai regardé The Boy in Striped
Pyjamas. Oh mon Dieu, donc c'est un peu déprimé maintenant. C'est un film super triste. Alors, raconte-moi ce qui se passe ou ce qui s'est passé dans ce film. Remember the expression, how do you say it's about?
S'agit de.
Il s'agit de. Lovely. Okay, il s'agit de. And I always stress the il because obviously half the time I'm telling you to jump to ça, but we'd say il s'agit de. Good. How would you say it was about?
Il s'agit.
Good. Spell s'agissait for me from the A onwards.
A-G-I-S-S-A-I-T.
Good boy. Okay, il s'agissait de quoi? Donc, il s'agit de quoi? De quoi il s'agit? C'est quoi l'histoire? What's the story?
Il s'agit d'un garçon.
Oui.
Qui habite en...
Quel pays? Allemagne?
Yeah.
Oui, qui habite en Allemagne. Ok. Quand est-ce qu'il habite en Allemagne? C'est un film moderne, c'est basé quand?
Pendant la guerre.
Très très bien. Pendant la guerre, oui, alors la guerre, comme tu as bien dit, like you said correctly, ça veut dire la Deuxième Guerre mondiale. Copie-moi, la Deuxième Guerre mondiale.
La Deuxième Guerre mondiale.
Oui, donc il s'agit d'un petit garçon qui habite en Allemagne. Ok, qui habite en Allemagne. Good. What could we do to give me that? Knock it up a little bit. You could be of German origin and live in frickin' France or something, but how would you say of German origin?
D'origine.
And then the next word?
D'origine. Allemande. Allemande.
Why? Because what's the gender of origine?
Feminine.
Good. How would you say I'm of Welsh origin?
D'origine.
Gotta know this one. Galloise. Galloise. Lovely. Double L. O-I-S. Good. Plus the E. Galloise. Okay. Mon père est gallois. Ma mère est galloise. Je suis d'origine galloise. Okay. If you said to somebody, vous êtes de quelle origine? I can hear the police horses coming past, which is nice. If you were speaking to somebody who ethnically didn't identify as Caucasian and you said that, it might on occasion be misinterpreted, like someone suggesting, oh, you're not French, for example. But largely, it means where you're from as opposed to what's your hereditary ethnic background. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, so il s'agit d'un petit garçon d'origine allemande qui habite pendant la guerre, whatever, okay, pendant la Deuxième Guerre mondiale. Et ensuite, qu'est-ce qui se passe après?
Alors, après ça,
Donc, c'est un film... Oui, c'est un film joyeux.
Déménagé.
Il a déménagé, oui, il a déménagé. D'où à où?
Je me souviens pas ça.
Je ne m'en souviens. You don't need to do ça, je m'en souviens pas. Ok, mais...
Je m'en souviens pas.
Mais il est arrivé où? Where did he arrive?
Il est arrivé à... I can't even remember.
Okay, give me... So basically in English, an overview.
In Berlin, I think.
Okay, give me an overview. Just roughly an overview in English. Just tell me five sentences about this film in English. Because at the moment, as far as I'm concerned, it's about a boy in Germany. Now, it could be like... So he did the can-can with a load of clowns and they all got wrecked on vodka. I mean, I know nothing, okay?
Okay, so it's based during the Second World War.
Yeah.
A little boy and his family move to the countryside.
Yeah.
Because his father is a high-ranking Nazi.
Mm-hmm.
So he gets put in charge of one of the concentration camps.
Good.
And the premise of the story is how it's concealed from both of the children. And then he finally manages to search around a bit and explore, and he comes across a fence. He sees a little boy there who's obviously part of the camp. He doesn't understand. He thinks he's just a farmer. He thinks they're just farmers.
Mm-hmm.
And he doesn't really understand what's going on. And then...
Is there something... I don't want to be a spoiler, but I've not seen it, but is there like some mistaken identity thing? Does he end up getting massacred like the other...
Yes, yeah. Pretty much.
Happy, happy, joy, joy. That's lovely, Callum. What a lovely film to watch after school.
School
was that good, but that cheered you up. Good, so off we go. So, it's about a boy. I'm going to feed it you, and then you're going to translate it. So, it's about a boy.
Il s'agit d'un garçon.
Okay, of German origin.
D'origine, is it?
Yeah, d'origine, yeah.
D'origine allemande.
Okay. He moves with his family. Present tense, because often when you're telling a story about a film, you'll say, so he does this, it's in the present tense, okay. Yeah, okay.
Il déménage avec sa famille.
Okay. Due to the fact that...
Dû au fait que...
Lovely, his dad has a military career.
Son père a...
Une carrière militaire. Lovely. Which at the time meant No, which at the time means, let's keep it present, which at the time?
Yes, ça veut dire.
Lovely, qui à l'époque.